Once upon a time, the three of us sat at this table, and we were having tea or something, I don't know what. And Wilma was telling us that she had been to Ireland.
I went to Irish Baha'i Summer School. They wanted me to participate. They said, would you please take the afternoon with all the girls, young girls, teenage girls? And I said, fine, I'll do that. All I said was, I introduced things, subjects. How is your school life going? And they really talked about their lives. I kept getting one theme that bothered me. And that was, I'm not really happy. And that got my attention, of course.
One of the factors that has really contributed to the success of our organization and our programs is the unwavering allegiance and commitment of our group of individuals to the mission statement of this organization. A few words in particular stand out: education, inspiration, and empowerment.
Remember when you were telling us about the conference, the women's conference, you've been to Ireland, how excited you were and how well done it was and how important it was for women to be involved in every strata of society.
A small yet mighty group of visionary men and women with humble means and golden hearts dedicated to shifting the paradigm and improving the cultures and attitudes about half of the world's population, and help bring in out those valuable and divinely endowed capacities, attributes, values, and contributions that could lift our humanity to new heights of excellence and glory. This is what Women on the Move Network does.
The most important thing that Women on the Move has done is not, we have not lost the vision.
Our Girl Talk program is designed to promote self-esteem, to develop life skills, inspire motivation to these young girls. It is a youth development program to encourage our girls to realize that they can become their own heroes.
Hi, my name is Savannah Compton, and I attended Girl Talk last summer. What I enjoyed about it is I enjoyed it because it was about how you can motivate yourself and have self-confidence.
There's a hero if you look inside your heart. You don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away.
I have enjoyed in supporting and encouraging these young girls, and I have seen how this program has impacted them. I have seen an increase of self-esteem. I have seen their confidence just increased. They are more confident when they do public speaking.
I'd like to thank Ms. Diaz for mentoring us. And last year we went to the conference of Girl Talk, and it was fun because we got to learn about how to be confident, and we learned about friendship and how to be careful on social media and homework tips and health tips.
Hi, my name is Sarah Fieta, and I am one of the girls that joined the Girl Talk program. And something that they taught us at the Girl Talk program was how to be organized and how to be career ready.
It took a group of individuals who shared the vision about this faith-inspired principle of gender equality. We all believed that nobility of every human soul could be maximized if we provided education, inspiration, and empowerment, and allowed them to contribute to the improvement and betterment of our society.
The fact that during those teenage years, if there's not a purpose that this is mine and this is what I'm contributing, then they feel a little adrift.
Respect, integrity, and nobility of spirit. That was going to be our focus.
We believe that through inspiring our youth and through believing in the power of faith and through empowering every individual to reach its capacity, that we could contribute to promoting peace and justice into our local communities, and they could each contribute to bringing about the equities and justice that we all desire to establish around us.
The flagship program that our institution is engaged in is Who is Your Hero? And Who is Your Hero program concentrates on educating, inspiring, and empowering young girls. Especially nowadays, this has been one of the most important activities that any community or any society can engage in.
We will succeed in developing self-confidence and making positive choices. We will develop leadership skills and recognize that we can become our own hero.
Peer pressure is not only direct, but it is also indirect. Peer pressure is known not only spoken, but is also unspoken. It can be very negative, and we also have positive peer pressure. So our program tries to create positive peer pressure and allow our girls to learn and to navigate around negative, unspoken peer pressure.
Having these women empowerment workshops for about 5 years. We talk on a variety of topics. It's a very intimate, comfortable space, and we make it as comfortable to be there so the women feel like they can.
We've had a number of workshops that really impacted the lives of the women and enabled them to make connections with each other, which is a very important aspect. It's the connections, it's the networking, it's the support, it's helping women to feel, whatever their issue, that they are not alone.
When you wish to change the cultures and the attitudes about half of the world population, you need partnership, you need healthy collaboration, and you need strong supporters and believers in your cause and your mission. We have been blessed to have the support and the benefit of many strong partners, such as colleges, universities, local institutions, financial supporters, and individuals who provided us with their volunteer hours, with their mentorship, and with their strong sense of support to allow us to continue with the work that we do.
We have been fortunate enough to have had funding from corporate sponsors such as Arconic, Macy's, Citizens Bank, and other local businesses. Obviously, we have also programs where we request sponsorship from individuals and organizations, but basically any donations are appreciated.
We are certainly continuing with the work that we have started, and we're going no place but forward and up.